My name is Dudile Mukwena from South Africa, and I work for Gender CC, Women for Climate Justice in Southern Africa. Very, very adversely. Currently, things are bad, especially in the urban area where I come from, because usually people who will be most affected will be people from rural areas, and mainly because their situation is compromised already and compounded by the climate change. People are seeing climate change right in the doorsteps of their houses. People suffering. We have a lot of heat waves. We have drought, and that has caused rivers and dams to dry up. We have now a shortage of water. We are now rationed when it comes to water, and you can just imagine how that is affecting women who have to see to it that they cook, they clean the houses, they provide water to their families in this very heated weather. And they've taken on doing small-scale household farming in their houses so that they can be able to provide, put food on the table for their families and also sustain their livelihoods. So that also is affected by drought, and also if it rains, it floods. So that is destabilizing their lives, their sustainability, and also their performance as women to take care of themselves, their families, and their children. And most of all, because now, besides the physical impacts that we experience for climate change, there are laws and policies that are related to climate change. Women are not even included. Their decisions are taken for them, not with them. The consultation from the government is not enough. Usually the scientists, the researchers, and business are consulted, but very poor, the people who are on the front line of climate change, are not consulted. So there's a lot of things that are affecting the women. They don't even have resources that they can use to have the resilience or to adapt to the climate change impact, to build that resilience. They don't have resources, they don't have any access to anything that can help their situation. It is important because we feel that decisions are just taken at the top level, and there's always this top-down approach which doesn't help people at the ground level. So we feel if these voices can be taken to this platform and they can hear and feel the needs and the frustrations and the seriousness of the problems, the challenges that women are facing at local level, perhaps that will help them to make an informed and inclusive decision, and open doors for local people to participate, and also hear from them, hear and listen to them, and take what they are saying, because they might be at local level, they might not have a technical know-how, they might not have knowledge that much, they might not have a legal background or whatever, but they know what is happening in their lives, and they are trying using their own local traditional indigenous knowledge to adapt and to use the most forms and the methods of agriculture, especially when it comes to farming, that they know, which can help the negotiators to come up with solutions, nature-based solutions that will also help to reduce the emissions.